Good morning everyone. In this session we are going to discuss with the fourth unit, expansion of the British rule. In the previous class already we have seen the other battles like Anglo-Maratha war, Anglo-Mysore war and Anglo-Sikh wars that we are going to see in this class. And also these are the wars that enabled the East India Company to establish a solid foothold in India. Okay, so that's what you are saying. So which are the wars that enabled the East India Company to establish their solid foothold in India? So first one, Anglo-Maratha wars, Anglo-Mysore war and also Anglo-Sikh wars. Okay, and also already you have seen Anglo-Maratha wars, Anglo-Mysore wars, Hyder Ali and also Tipu Sultan, already you have seen their contribution, everything you have seen. And also Hyder Ali is a just like a brilliant administrator, everything you have seen, no? So come to the next one, Anglo-Sikh wars, let's say Punjab. Okay, so come page number 57. Okay, the Sikhs resisted against the British under the Maharaja Ranjit Singh. However, after his death in 1839, then the British Governor General Lord Ellenborough and his successor means a person that succeeded another, okay, Sir Hardinge, felt the need to control the Khalsa. So what is Khalsa? Khalsa, we can say it is a company fully initiated by the Sikh. Okay, that's it. Okay, so which they felt had grown too powerful. Okay, so here we can see the Sikhs resisted. Okay, Sikh resisted against the British with the help of who is that administrator? Maharaja Ranjit Singh. So after the death of Maharaja Ranjit Singh, what happened after the death in 1839? Because they lost their control and also Britishes, they need to control what the Khalsa, which became very powerful, which became very too powerful, that we can see. Okay, so the Sikhs resisted because they resisted the Sikh resisted the British with the help of Maharaja. You just underline Maharaja Ranjit Singh. So after the death of Ranjit Singh, okay, 1839, okay, then the British Governor General Lord Ellenborough and his successor Sir Hardinge, okay, Hardinge felt the need to control the Khalsa. Khalsa already said it is a company, okay, company or fully initiated by Sikh. Okay, then they need to control over who? Lord, okay, Governor General Lord Ellenborough and his successor Sir Hardinge. Okay, so which they felt had grown too powerful, okay, that became too powerful, that's only they need to control. Okay, then what happened? With the help of the units from the Bengal army, what happened? They won decisive victories, resulting in, what is the result? Partial subjugation. What is partial? One side of the subjugation. One side means, especially subjugation means to bring under control, or we can say conquer. Okay, so the Sikh kingdom is under control of them, of the British, that is what we are saying. Okay, that's about that paragraph. And also come to the next one. In the second Anglo-Sikh wars in 1848, Lord Dalhousie attacked the Sikhs, who lost heavily and had to surrender in March 1849. You just underline all the eras, 1849, and also Maharaja Ranjit Singh. Okay, after the death, when he died, okay, you can just underline, okay, all the date, everything. Okay, and also Punjab was annexed to the British territory and it came to be known as the Northwest Frontier Province of India. So what is it here? We can see in the second Anglo-Sikh wars in 1848, okay, the Lord Dalhousie, okay, he organized and also attacked Sikh. Lord Dalhousie attacked the Sikhs and also who lost heavily and had to surrender in March 1849, okay, in the war, just like a Punjab, Sikhs, they lost heavily and also they have to surrender something. What is a surrender? Punjab, okay, surrender Punjab, already it is there, okay. So the Punjab was annexed to the British territory. Punjab was annexed means what? Just like a, what you can say, add, we can say just like a joining with, or just like a take part, or subordinate, we can say, many meanings are there, okay. So the Punjab was annexed after the war of Sikhs, okay, already in that war, okay, just like in the second Anglo-Sikh wars in 1848, the Sikhs, they lost heavily and they had to surrender something, so they surrendered Punjab, okay. So Punjab was annexed to the British, okay, annexed means it's like add with the British, okay, territory, the British territory, and came to be known as, and so this is to known as what is the northwest frontier province of India. Okay, that's about. And so these three powers, namely, okay, which are the three powers? Okay, who fought against the British? Already must be have seen. Just like this enabled the English East India Company to establish their solid footholds in India. So which are the three powers? Maratha and Mysore and last one Sikwas. Okay. So these three powers, namely Maratha, Sultan, Sultan of Mysore, already we have seen Hyderabad and Tipu Sultan, okay, Mysore, and six challenged the British, okay, challenged the English presence in the subcontinent, okay. So but what was the result? But these wars gave the English a chance to dominate means control over, dominate means just like have power, have complete power, we can say, okay. So have power, dominate most of the territories in India, okay, through this war. Already you have seen, no, that is the same thing, okay, because only through this war they can enable their East India Company to improve, just like they can establish their solid foothold, okay, foothold in India, that's what, okay. Then what happened? Which were earlier under control of these Indian powers, okay, it was there because earlier it was controlled by Indian, okay, India's, okay. So by 1857, the British had acquired all these territories. I told you, see, now 1857, the British had acquired all these territories: Maratha, Mysore, and Sikhs. Okay. So some of the territories were as administered directly, and also that is our specialty. Some of them they administered directly. Then what is at the same time by the English East India Company? While there were much smaller kingdoms, okay, that is controlled by indirectly, that is there, okay, which were indirectly controlled by the British through various means like a subsidiary alliance and a doctrine of lapsay. Let us read about them in detail, okay. These are the subsidiary alliance and a doctrine of lapsay, okay. These are the, okay, I think these things they controlled indirectly, okay, that's right. Let us read them. The first one, subsidiary alliance, okay. So it was introduced by, who introduced this one? Subsidiary alliance. If any question comes, you just write subsidiary alliance. It is introduced by Lord Wellesley. So it was introduced by Lord Wellesley, underline, okay. So under this system, so what is this system? Next question, come on. It was a system wherein, okay, where means just like a, we can say where means in which, okay, in which the rulers of Indian princely states could continue to reign with an assurance of protection from the British in times of strife. Strife means if there is any problem or any war, okay. So you have to just assure, just like the Britishers are supporting or just like protecting them from any wars, okay, protecting the princely states, okay, that's what. And so since the princely states could question the supremacy to the supremacy of the English, and also they are the supreme power, who the Britishers are the supreme or superiority, so they have to ask the questions, okay, if they wanted to do anything, they have to ask the supreme power. Who is the supreme power? That is the Britishers, okay. Okay, they reluctantly signed this agreement with the English. Reluctantly means what? Just like a note, just like a hesitant way or unwillingly. The princely states, no, they unwillingly, reluctantly signed this agreement with the English, because everything is controlled by the British, and so they don't have any power. Because if they want to take any decision, and so if they have any problem, because they will arrange it, so they will control it, so they will take the final decision. They are the supreme power. That's why they are the supremacy. Okay, supremacy means just like a superior. Okay, superior to the princely state. So if they want to take any decision, they have to approach Britishers. So they reluctantly, they means the princely state, they reluctantly signed this agreement with the English. Okay, what is that under this agreement? Okay, what we can see? The Indian kingdoms would have to maintain a certain number of British troops. That is the first one, underline, okay. Indian kingdoms would have to maintain, they have to maintain certain number of British troops. Okay, the first one, British troops, they have to maintain the British troops. Next one, there would be a British resident, that should be there, British resident posted in the Indian courts. Just like in the Indian courts, there should be a British resident, okay, one should be there, just like American resident, and also just like, okay, if you are going there, या जैसे कि इंडियन रेसिडेंट लाइक सेम वे ओके दैट इज द सेकंड वन जस्ट अंडरलाइन ओके दिस आर द एग्रीमेंट अंडर दिस एग्रीमेंट व्हिच एग्रीमेंट सब्सिडियरी अलायंस ओके सो द थर्ड वन द किंग कुड नॉट अप्रोच एनी फॉरेनर विदाउट द परमिशन ऑफ द ब्रिटिश रेसिडेंट इन द पोर्ट एंड सो दे डोंट हैव एनी राइट टू अलो ओके अप्रोच एनी फॉरेनर विदाउट द परमिशन ऑफ द ब्रिटिश resident in the court that's all so these are the three okay under this agreement these are the agreement okay then states like Mysore Hyderabad Awadh Marathas and Rajput kingdoms were forced to accept this alliance after being defeated in regional wars and so after defeating them they have to accept forcefully okay that's it states like Mysore Hyderabad Awadh Marathas and Rajputs kingdoms were forced to accept because they were against this but they were forced to accept after the defeat okay after the war so that's it so continue up to there you don't have any doubt come to the next one the second one is doctrine of lapsing as you already have seen subsidiary rights okay these are things the British they controlled indirectly okay so come to the next one what is there so doctrine of lapsing okay according to the Indian tradition kings were expected to adopt an heir to the throne if they did not have a son of their own okay what's the meaning adopt means legally take or legally just like we can take okay then what is the meaning of heir heir means a person legally entitled to the property or we can say a rank of another on that person's death and also in this according to the Indian tradition okay they can adopt the kings can adopt the heir to the throne if the king did not have a son of their own and also so there that is a right okay that is a Indian traditional right okay Indian tradition according to the Indian tradition so what happened this was they were against it means the British what happened next the tradition was not acceptable to the British and also they are not accepted this Indian tradition so what was their policy to see the new governor general lord Dalhousie introduced a new policy known as doctrine of lapsing and also they were against the Indian tradition and also they introduced a new policy that is known as doctrine of lapsing okay that's it and also according to this policy just underline according to this policy what is that if the king did not have any natural born means his own son okay what happened then the kingdom would lapse to the British lapse means the kingdom is controlled by the British okay under control of British judgment everything is taken by the British that's all okay or would be administered and occupied by the British that's the meaning you just underline okay according to this policy okay if the king did not have any natural born or heir we can see or born heir then the kingdom would lapse or we can say or administered or occupied by the British is just underline okay so thus the British invented new ways through which they could acquire more territories in India so they just like tried okay new ways through which they could acquire more they wanted to acquire more and also more from the territories of India as well okay then states like Satara 1848 Nagpur and Jhansi 1857 were annexed means take part or add okay that we can say or we can say extra okay under this policy which policy doctrine of lapsing okay already got the idea about lapsing you just underline okay according to the Indian tradition and also they were against the Indian tradition and also they are giving importance to their own policy okay so direct annexation already know just like you already know the word what is annexation just like and also just like joining with something okay so if no other method was available to the British for expansion okay then the only other way was war simply annexation okay so if other method okay if no other method was available to the British for expansion they wanted to expand so they started a war and also then only other way was war or simply we can say annexation means just like capturing or just add with the coordinate Punjab and Sindh were annexed means already added on grounds of misgovernment only because of their misgovernment because they are not at all doing properly just like a misgovernment okay and poor administration that's the main reason poor administration that's only they annexed who the Britishers annexed पंजाब एंड सिंध ऑलरेडी आर सीन द पंजाब ऑलरेडी आर सीन नो आफ्टर डेथ ऑफ महाराजा रंजीत सिंह दे लॉस्ट देयर पावर्स ऑफ ब्रिटिश कैप्चर्ड लाइक दिस दे एनेक्स्ड ओके देन व्हाट हैपेंड एंड अब्सॉर्बड इनटू ब्रिटिश एंपायर अब्सॉर्ब मींस इट्स लाइक जॉइंड विद ओके जस्ट लाइक यू वी कैन से हैविंग फुल्ली एंगेज्ड विद ओके एंगेज्ड विद द ब्रिटिश एंपायर ओके then Surat and Tanjore okay Tanjore were also annexed their rulers were pensioned off means those who are ruling there okay they were out okay that's a time to leave okay they were just like what we can say pensioned off to leave the place and also the administration is taking control by Britishers because everything is controlled by the Britishers and also those who are ruling there they are pensioned off means they have to leave from there that's the meaning of pensioned off okay and also Surat and Tanjore were also annexed and their rulers were pensioned off. That's the meaning. Okay, pensioned off you got, I think. Okay, so pensioned off means those who are ruling there, they have to leave and also British took them in charge. Okay, they are controlling the rulers. And come to the next one, annexation of Awadh. It means in 1856, Lord Dalhousie went on to annex. Annexation means just like an aad or subordinate, we can say. Just like a, okay, support aad or just like extra, we can say. Okay, annex Awadh. On the pretext, and also who is the ruler of Awadh in that time? We can say that is coming Wajid Ali Shah. Okay, and also annex Awadh on the pretext. Pretext means just like a justification of misgovernance in the state. And also who is control over the place? Just like who is ruling? Wajid Ali Shah, the ruler of the Awadh, has been the loyal British ally. Ally means what? Just like a cooperating with the Britishers. Okay, he is doing all the just like a kind and. Just like an honest man, and also with the ally with the British, that means cooperating with the British. Who is the ruler of Awadh? Who is that person? Just like a Wajid Ali Shah. Okay. And Dalhousie. So Dalhousie became very unpopular because of this act. Which act? Which is an annexation of the Awadh. Okay. Because he is very loyal to the who? The ruler of Awadh. Dalhousie Wajid Ali Shah. He is very loyal to the British. Okay. Loyal to the British ally, okay. Loyal to the British ally, cooperating with the British. That's what. That's why he became very unpopular with this rule, which rule? Annexation of the Awadh. That's why. And also, thus by the first half of the 19th century, the English East India Company became political masters of the subcontinent. Some of the other factors which helped them are given below. And also, how the if any question comes, how the East India Company became political masters of the subcontinent. So let us see the points. Okay, some factors are there. See, first one we just said disunity among the Indian rulers. That is the first reason. Okay, disunity among the Indian rulers. That was there. I think in the beginning itself we can see okay disunity among the Indian rulers ensured their downfall. Okay, that ensured the downfall in the backgrounds of the British policy of divide and rule. Okay, so the main reason is that disunity among the Indian rulers, okay, that ensured the downfalls in the background. Okay. So next one, second one, Britain was already strong in the industrial power. How they became strong? Very strong. Okay, let us see. Okay, Britain was already a strong industrial power. Owing to the industrial revolution, the British used India, and also they considered India as a market for their factory and made goods. And also they are considering just like a factory. Okay, factory goods. And also they consider, and also actually it is a change from traditional goods to just like a colonial. Okay, that we can see just like a, they are destroying the Britishes, destroying the traditional Indian economy. That's what it is saying. Change from tradition to colonial economy. Okay, this in turn helped them establish a political domain. They destroyed everything what we have in India. No, everything they destroyed, and also at last. They have the political domain. Okay, in turn, this in turn helped them establish the political domination. Okay, all the good things they have exported from India, and also they imported all the low qualities. Okay, all the spices they exported everything, and also they are giving the just like what is that normal, just like the cheap qualities. Actually, we can say they improved, they established the British political domain. Okay, or domination. Okay, who established political domain? British. That's all. So with this, I am going to wind up this session. So if you have any doubt regarding this, you just contact. And also the very next session, the very next class, we will discuss the questions. I will give the answers in PDF. Okay. So and also if you get the time tomorrow, we will start the next chapter, chapter 5, the impact of British rule. Okay, I think that is a short chapter. Okay, so with this I am going to wind up this session. So thank you.